after having these experiences, these ecstatic religious experiences, and these experiences of totally emptying out his mind and entering the sphere of nothingness, and having these kind of peak states of these yogic practices, and then doing extreme renunciation, the Buddha still was looking for a kind of understanding of reality that reconciled what he had seen in life, a privileged life of having everything, and the hard edge of life, of birth and death and sickness and aging, and the answer to human dissatisfaction and suffering. And with that quest, the Buddha continued. He left the forest and sat by a lake. And at that time, a woman was passing by and saw him and thought that he was waiting there begging for food. And so she offered him some honey and cream or rice pudding. And he took this and ate some of it. And he had been doing so much meditation practice and so many of these inner yogic practices and mystical experiences that as soon as he took this food in, he had a kind of insight, which was the insight into the middle way of the path. And he realized that the spiritual realization that he was looking for wasn't to be found in these extremes. And because he had been fasting and doing such extreme experiences, it was in a way like this nourishment, this food suddenly allowed all of that to take hold. Those practices still had effect, and all the teachings that he had received from the teachers he'd had before were there, and they had the effect, and he put all of this understanding together in this insight into the path. And probably this is one of the turning points in the Buddha's life story that we overlook, that the first Buddhist was Sujata, this woman who approached him and made the first offering to him as he had that insight into the nature of the path. And with that insight in mind, the Buddha decided to sit down, and in that one day and one night that he sat down to meditate on this realization, he had what was known as his awakening, or the Buddha's enlightenment.